Hello students, in today's session we will go through the topics of national development and how to compare different countries or states. Students, in the last session we had seen different developmental goals of different people. There is no similarity or comparison between people with their goals. Each of them has their own goals, isn't it? Every people has their own ambitions and goals. So the definition of development for different people are different. There is no similarity between people for developmental goals. Like in individual case, the expectations of the people towards national development is also different. People have different opinions and suggestions for national development. People give their opinions and suggestions for the development of the nation because people are free to give their opinions. So it is very important to keep in mind that different persons could have different as well as conflicting notions of a country's development. What do you mean by conflicting notions? There is different ideas of people having their country's development. Next is that how to compare different countries or states. What is the criteria to compare different countries or states? When we compare different things, they could have similarities as well as differences. Then how can we compare a country with other? What is the criteria for this? Let's see. Look at different students in the class. Suppose if we have to compare the students of a class, what criteria to be followed? How can we compare students to students? How do we compare these students? Because the talents or efficiencies of different students are different. There is no uniformity. Then what criteria will be followed to compare the students of a class? They differ in their height, health, talents, and interest. Do you know, children? The healthiest student may not be the most studious one. The most intelligent student may not be the friendliest one. Isn't it? So, how do we compare students? This is the problem. So, there should be a common criteria to be used to compare the students of a class. So, the criterion we may use depends on the purpose of comparison. Why do we compare? That purpose should be there. On the basis of the purpose, we should set the criteria. Usually, we take one or more important characteristics of persons and compare them based on these characteristics. We take one or more characteristics for comparing persons, and on the basis of that, we do that comparisons. Of course, there can be differences about what are important characteristics that should form the basis of comparison. This is very important. What can be important and what are important characteristics? That is the basis of comparison. So, the basis of comparisons may be friendliness, spirit of cooperation, creativity, or marks secured. So these may be the basis of comparison. So this is true of development too. When we compare children, we compare maybe their health, maybe their friendliness, maybe their spirit of cooperation, maybe their talent, maybe their interest of different work. Same should be applicable in case of comparing the development of a country. Some criteria should be there. For comparing countries, the criteria should be different. What should be the criteria, or what is the purpose of comparison? So on the basis of the purpose of comparison, criteria should be set. See, for comparing the countries, their income is considered to be one of the most important criteria. When we take the comparison of countries, we first of all consider income. Income is the major criteria to compare countries to country or state to state. When we speak about income, we see average income. Now, what is average income? Or how can we calculate average income? Average income can be calculated by dividing total income by total population. Then we get average income. This is also known as per capita income. Per capita income, that is per head income. So per head income, that is the main criteria to be used to compare countries to country. According to the World Development Report brought out by the World Bank, the criteria used is that countries with per capita income of 4,53,000 per annum and above in 2004 are called rich countries. See, here the World Bank set the criteria of per capita income. If the per capita income of a country is 4,53,000 per annum, is called as rich country. This criteria they set in 2004. Those with the per capita income of 37,000 or less are called low income countries. See the difference. The countries having 4,53,000 per capita income is considered as rich countries, or the countries having the per capita income of 37,000 or less are called low income countries. See, for comparing countries, income is the major criteria used here. Now, India comes under low income countries. Why? Why India comes under low income countries? Because our per capita income was only 28,000 per annum in 2004. That is far, far below than the expected per capita income one country should have. Those countries having lakhs of per capita income comes in rich countries, and those countries per capita income is very less. That is 28,000 only is called low income countries or underdeveloped countries. The rich countries are generally called developed countries. Why these countries are called developed countries? Because the per capita income of these countries are very high. The per capita income, you know children, it is calculated from total income by total population. Now, the next thing is that while we use averages, there are some disparities are there. Average income, that is not the fair means to compare two countries. Through this table, it is very clear that the division of income within the country is different. For example, there are two countries given, country A and B. C, income has been distributed among five people. This is an example of country A. Here, income has been distributed more or less same. When we calculate the average income, the people of that country is getting 8,200 rupees, their average income per month they are getting. This is monthly income. Monthly income of five people are given there, and their average income per month is 8,200. Because first person is getting 9,500, second person 10,500, third person 9,800, fourth person 1,000, and the fifth person is 10,200. These are the different criteria. Yes, fourth person is 10,000 and not 1,000, 10,000. So while we calculate all the five income together by dividing with five, we get 8,200. Now you come to the second country. Here, majority people are getting 500 rupees per month. Only 500. But the fifth person is getting the income of 48,000. Here also, when we calculate the total income, we get much amount, more amount, and we calculate the per head income of that country, everyone is getting 10,000, which is more than the first country. But see, the income distribution is very different. There is disparity in the distribution of income in second case, but nobody knows it. So average income hides disparities. Nobody knows how income is distributed in that country. But we see average income, the average income of every person is 10,000. But reality is something different. The reality is that majority people are getting very low income and only few are getting higher income. So this is the disparity we see while calculating average income. So average income hides disparities. So average income is not the fair criteria to compare countries. So this is the main limitation of average income. In next session, we will discuss the remaining part of the chapter. That's all for today.